Leander Paes, one of the best doubles players of all time, keeping the U.S. Open dream alive. You've won here before. You won your opening round. So how's the fortnight going?
Well, the team's got some good rhythm now. I think World Team Tennis kind of set it up. Coming into Cincinnati last week, where we did really well, had a win there. So for us, it's about just keeping the rhythm, you know, about on an off day like today, just keeping the strokes going, keeping the serve sharp, keeping the return sharp. And when it comes to playing the matches, just finding a way to win.
Leander, you've done it all on the tennis court, and the passion you have for World Team Tennis is unbelievable. The fire in your eyes. What is it about that league that you love so much?
Firstly, it's the respect that I have for Billie Jean King. I think she epitomizes what an athlete should be. The way she's looked after me over the 3 seasons that I played team tennis, Ilana and Billie's team have looked after me amazingly well. And then it's my owner, my boss, Mark Hine. The Washington Castles are a great organization. Everyone on that organization does their bit to make sure we players are healthy, happy, and have no stress whatsoever, so we can perform with a clear mind. And for me, Mark's a great friend and a perfectionist, and that's why I love playing for him. Also, on saying that, my teammates, they're a great team. Each and every one of us are individual characters.
And how about playing with Venus Williams? You guys are quite the team.
Yes, it's always fun playing with Venus. She's a great tennis player, but what really gets me more about Venus is what a great person she is. Her understanding of the game of tennis is well documented, but her understanding of life and of people's skills is really phenomenal. So I love playing with Venus and Serena.
Are you a little concerned Venus pulling out of this? Hopefully she'll be okay.
I hope she's okay. She's just a great asset for the game of tennis. She's a great asset for the U.S. Open, especially in her home Grand Slam. So it's a bit tough for her, and I feel for her having to pull out.
And for this tournament, how are the courts playing so far? I mean, you played on the World Team Tennis hard courts. How are these courts playing?
The courts are playing great. They are playing kind of quick. They are quicker than the other hard courts in the season, but this year is a little slower than what the courts were last year. So every week you're going to get a mix of different courts. And for me, coming into New York and soaking in the energy of the city and bringing it out into the matches is what it's all about.
Final question. You've won a World Team Tennis title. What's next for you? How can you even do better than that?
You know, it's going to be really tough topping this season. I won it as a rookie in my first year and got MVP in that season. And I said that it's going to be tough to top that. And this year we got MVP, we won the season, and it was an undefeated season. It's going to be tough for any team to better that. And next year we got to be ready, because every other team are going to be gunning for us. And at the same time, if you lose one match, everyone's going to say, what's happened? What's happened to your form? But really, that's the beauty of sport. The margins between winning and losing are so minute that at the end of the day, you've got to keep it real. And that's why I like tennis. Our rankings change every Monday of every week.
Well, Leander Paes is a great friend, a class act. Great seeing Leander Paes here in New York, a World Team Tennis veteran, also a World Team Tennis champion with the Castles.